छाओ दैट वी हैव टू कंडोल पासिंग द अवे ऑफ मिस्टर एम एन सीतारामन फॉर्मर हेड लाइब्रेरी एंड इन्फो सेंटर नेशनल एरोनॉटिकल लैब बेंगलुरु हु लेफ्ट फॉर द हेवनली अबोर्ड ऑन 22nd मे 2021. He was one of the pioneering in library and information science of our country at the formative years of the development of library of the information system in our country. I'm not going to take too much time about M.N. Sitaraman, but personally I met him twice or thrice, and people are going to talk about him more, who are all worked with M.N. Sitaraman. And in same time, Karnataka Library Association would like to condole some of the LIS professionals, my colleagues who passed the recent days, R.S. Kumbar from National Law School of India, Aditya Ranjan from Ajim Prem University, Mr. R. Dandapani from British Library, Bengaluru, and Mr. Manjunatha, Assistant Librarian, BMS College, Bengaluru. They also left for the Heavenly Award. With these small remarks, now I request you all to mourn 1 minute silence.
एक स्टाइल है
Okay, thank you. Now there are speakers that are going to give a respect to M.N. Sitaraman. For 3 minutes. So each speaker, please stick on to that, because there are 10 speakers. They are going to speak. Please make that convenient. Now I request Professor K.S. Raghavan to pay respect to Mr. M.N. Sitaraman. Over to Professor K.S. Raghavan, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Krishnamurthy. Thank you for asking me to be a part of this meeting. It's indeed a sad day that we are mourning the passing of several leaders in the profession, and Sri M.N. Sitaraman was certainly one of them. I first met Mr. Sitaraman. I've never really worked with him, but I met him at the office of the Librarian of Indian Institute of Science, Professor T.K.S. Iyengar. After I finished my master's in Delhi, I was looking for a job, and one of the first places that I science library, and Mr. Sitaraman was in a meeting with Professor T.K.S. Iyengar, and that's where I met him. That evening, I also met Professor Gopinath, Professor Neelamegan. And the next morning, I got a call from Sri Sitaraman asking me to appear for an interview at the National Aeronautical Laboratory for a position in the library. I went there. I was interviewed by Mr. Sitaraman and Mr. T. Rangarathan. Both of them were working there in the library. And later by one Mr. Valluri, I think he was the deputy director of NAL at that time. And they asked me to fill up a form. It didn't come through. It simply did not come through because the deadline for application for that particular position was over and date of that, you know, before the deadline. But what impressed me most about Mr. Sitaraman was, you know, his interest in attracting, getting people to work with him. Once he came to know of somebody, you know, he would try and get people to his fold and work with him. That was one of his greatest qualities. They're recognizing people, recognizing talent. And in that, it's very difficult to come across many such people, and Sitaraman was one of them. A great organizer, an exceptionally great organizer. That's one of his most outstanding qualities that I have come across. We have had practically, he used to be a regular DDRTC annual seminars, and we used to exchange notes after I joined the University of Mysore. But we had another occasion where we had to work together. That was when he became head of the library at the Indian Institute of Technology, Chennai. I was professor and head of the Department of Library Science in the University of Madras. And that year happened to be the you know, birth centenary year of Dr. S.R. Ranganathan. And the president of the Indian Library Association was very keen that we should have the All India Library Conference in Chennai. And I bluntly refused. I said, I don't have the facilities in Madras University. But then P.S.C. Kumar and Vasisht went to Professor Parthasarathi's house in Triplicana and brought him by afternoon. And Professor Parthasarathi simply told me, you accept it. I could not say no. But then Professor Parthasarathi roped in Mr. Sitaraman as one of the organizing secretaries. That is, besides me, Mr. Sitaraman became the other organizing secretary of the. What happened at the ILA conference in Chennai, the volume, the content, the outcome of that particular conference, something which has not happened in the history of ILA either before or since the 19th. That particular conference we hosted, in every respect, it was something that was outstanding, and much of it I owe to Dr. Sitaraman and two of his colleagues, Mr. Ayaran Gowda and Mr. Koteshwar Rao. Both of them were his deputies at that particular time, and then the ability that Dr. Sitaraman had to, you know, bring people together and work as a team was something really amazing. What he did at NAL, National Aerospace Laboratories, now earlier it was National Aeronautical Laboratory, it was among the first to introduce online information services in the country, much before any other institution that even thought about it. That was one of his greatest contributions to information systems and services. I mean, I can go on about his qualities, but you know, as I said, he was an extremely friendly person, and his greatest quality was to work, you know, develop, build a team, and to work with them as a member of the team. This organization ability is something outstanding, I would say. Outstanding, really outstanding. Even after he retired from the National Aerospace Laboratory, he continued to remain very active. You seldom come across people who have remained so very active even after retirement. Until very, very recently, he remained very active in information service provision. I mean, keep doing. And I have it from his teacher, Professor S. Partha Sarathy, that Mr. Sitaraman was his most favorite student. And abilities were something, you know, Professor Partha Sarathy does not normally, it's very difficult to get a good word of appreciation from Professor Partha Sarathy. He's always so very modest. But about Sitaraman, he would simply say that he's one of my most outstanding students. His loss is an irreparable loss to the entire profession. And friends, I join every one of you in mourning his demise, and I wish and pray that the members of the bereaved family have the strength to bear the loss. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Now I request Dr. A.R.N. Gowdar. Over to Gowdar. Please restrict your time, sir.
Yeah, I will try.
You have a lot of information, but still.
Yeah, I know. Don't worry about it.
Thank you.
Okay. Few things which probably you may not get from others. I plan to just read whatever I have written about M.N. Sitaraman. At the very first outset, let me thank Kala and the office bearers for this arrangement of remembering Dr. M.N. Sitaraman and his contributions, etc. Well, he joined NCL Pune immediately after his getting his master's in international relations from University of Pune in 1957. The same year, he joined NAL from NCL. He moved to NAL and he started working as a liaison officer for UNDP funded project, that is Wind Tunnel project. Later, he became head of information coordination section. In 1965, he became head of NAL library, and which later on became as ICA, that is Information Center for Aeronautics. He was deputed to INSDOC for doing his associateship in information science in 66-67. He also underwent an advanced practical training in information management in Commission for European Economic Communities, Luxembourg, and ESA, Frascati. He built NAL Information Center almost from the scratch to a highest level so as to get highest recognition from NISAT, ARNDB of DRDO, NASA, and UNESCO as one of the top sectoral information center for aeronautics in India. As LIS profession, he has many firsts to his credit. Already one is mentioned by Professor Raghavan. Very interestingly, he started using ICT applications as back as in 1970 itself. Can you believe he started using punch cards for issuing the books in the circulation section in 1970s. He developed MicroStar, a microprocessor-based information retrieval system in collaboration with NISAT, using NISAT funds. For the first time in India, as Professor Raghavan mentioned, he developed a dedicated hot link from NAL to ESA IRS to access online data bases like Data Star and many other dialogue, etc. He was first in the country to arrange airlifting of say journals, books, etc. from other countries. He developed an institutional ILL in a very good way, in such a way, for example, I can say that every week we used to run one bus from NAL to IASA and RRI. That was the sort of spirit he had for the Cooperation for the information management. Indira Gandhi Center for Arts, Delhi, Steel Authority of Limited, Ranchi. He had many first his credit apart from usual things like he has started a nice library training scheme in NAL. He also supplied useful information for the development of LCA and ALH of HAL and ADA. Apart from serving NAL, after his retirement, he served IIT Chennai as a special officer. Well, he brought a very good name for the profession at IIT Chennai. To such an extent, I would like to quote an example there. The Senate of IIT gave a standing ovation for remembering his services, for appreciating his services. He also worked as a project manager at GIST, a private company. And he also worked as a senior consultant in RB TriFac Center. And for 3 years, he used to bring out a journal called Advantage. And he was a very, very ambitious person. Always I used to say, sir, you'll be putting the staircase to the sky. He was such a person. There was no second thought in his history at all. He was so enthusiastic. Even till the end of his last day, that even at the age of 94, he was so much enthusiastic. And being in the hospital, he was so good. He, in fact, took out his oxygen mask to some extent, and he spoke to me for about 4 to 5 minutes. And then onwards, for 4 or 5 days, he went on sending the messages, being on the hospital bed. He was such a person. In fact, his son Raju was here. Nagarajan was very much here. And Nagarajan himself was so much scared and he was so much afraid. He sent a word through the doctor to his son, tell Nagarajan that let him not worry, I will come back. You know, he had that sort of courage. You know, he was so courageous. Even at almost a few days back, when he went to the hospital, he was working with the internet. He used to send me messages, Gowda, you should do this job, you should do this service, like that. He was a person of that kind. Really, we lost a wonderful personality. For me, he was much beyond a friend, much beyond a colleague, much beyond a guru, much beyond anything you say it was he. But I should also remember his wife, Mami, at this time, who also unfortunately met a very bad death almost 4 years back. And she was such a wonderful lady that there was no time when I came back without getting her hospitality. Such was the family of Sitaraman. Anyway, there are other people to speak about him. So I only pray God that let God give courage to his family members to bear this as well to all the colleagues, both professional outside as well as NAL colleagues. I know quite a good number of NAL colleagues are attending this program. I'm happy that they are in a position to attend and give homage to our dear MNS. Thank you. Thank you, Kala.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Now I request Dr. M. Koteswar Rao. Over to Koteswar Rao.
I'm glad that many people are have joined this program to express their condolences to Dr. Sitaraman. And I'm glad that Kala has organizing this program. I'm very happy to see some of the faces which I have not seen for many years, right from my student days till my career in IIT Madras. Now, first of all, let me say that we have lost a great library professional. That much I can say. Because as an individual, as a library professional, he is par excellence. Because I have worked with him only for 4 years. Because my first experience was in Bangalore. Then I moved to IIT Madras. Then myself, Dr. Gowdar and Venga, the three of us worked under him for nearly 4 years. But those 4 years, I could say, they're the best part in our career. Because working with him is really a challenge. He's a manager, and nobody can really question him. There's nobody else in the profession, I could say, that he's such an excellent manager to do things. He never stops working. Literally, he's a workaholic. And you know, once he accomplishes one job, he used to go to the other one. Like Professor Raghavan was saying, he never sleeps. Let me tell you, he never sleeps. That was the kind of work which he used to do. You know, since this COVID is there, and we are not, I'm sure that many of the people listen to Sitaraman, and then probably let others also say about him. And this loss is great to the library profession, I can say. Because, okay, we have seen recently, you know, Professor Parthasarathy passed away, Dr. Amudavalli passed away. We have lost a lot of friends and colleagues in the profession. This is very unfortunate, partly because of COVID and partly because of the age. This is one thing. And as I said, I'm really fortunate to work under him, along with me, my colleagues. As the order has told, he has taken IIT Madras Library from A to E. In the sense, what was IIT Library in 91 or 90 when he joined? And what was IIT Madras Library by the time he left? It is something amazing. I think nobody, I would say nobody, even in the current generation, has taken a library to such a extent, such a height. Because, you know, we can say he's our guide, mentor, or whatever it is. But, you know, he used to drive people to achieve something. He used to set targets and achieve something. Once he completes that, then again, he looks for something new. So let me give an example. He started the library automation very fast. I mean, at the time, I think not many academic libraries were fully automated. The only thing was Kanpur. IIT Kanpur, and number two was IIT Madras. That's how he took a project, library computerization, and then finally automated the circulation system. Then he introduced the CD-ROM servers, CD-ROM service. Then all of a sudden, at the time, there was no internet, but still he thought of, because of his past experience in NAL, we had a dial-up modem and we were able to access dial-up. We used to access dial-up database and provide
services
to the there is a time constraint. There is a time constraint.
Yes, sir. Please, there are so many speakers are there.
So then, with the dial-up modem, we used to access the dial-up database and provide the output to the industrial members. At a very cost. I mean, they used to earn money. The real aspect of library marketing is done and shown by Mr. Sitaraman. I think many libraries will not be able to do any marketing kind of thing, but he is able to show. And he's created a lot of things for the first time in the country, I would say. Let's say for the graduate trainees. So he used to encourage the young library professionals to join IITs for 2 years, give them training, give them some salary, and then get some job. That is the kind of thing which is very, very never heard about it. Industrial membership is another thing which has done. And then the library building. I would say that he's the architect of the library. I think many people simply give it to the contractor or administration. But here he has visualized, literally he has visualized how a library has to be. He has given a pre-plan so that the architect designs. And finally, whatever the building today is the actually the this thing of Mr. Sitaraman. And he has even undertaken some projects also. Not many libraries really do that, but he has been able to get money from AICT, DST, okay, and Aerospace Development Board. And he has contributed a lot to the information generation product also. And as a person, I would like to say that he's such a humble person, down to earth, never ambitious. He's never ambitious for power or money or anything. And he never tried to look down upon his subordinates or other staff. He was so friendly with the staff, and he used to inquire about their family, children, and their welfare. And he used to even motivate some of the lower level staff to study EBSC and BBC, and then get some jobs off. That's the kind of person he is. And you know, it's very rare to find such people, as Professor Raghavan was saying. Yeah, librarian is librarian, a professor is a professor. But you know, a humble person, down to earth, mixing with people, helping. Helping each other. In that way, he has created an image for a library. Previous to Mr. Sitaraman, we had Nazir Ahmad for a very long period. After his retirement, Sitaraman took over, and that's how he got into it in 91. And then with all that, we had they were able to take the library to a next height. For example, we introduced a lot of things, all the three people, and we have completed the stock verification after 20 years. Okay, there was a backlog of binding. That's nearly, but again, for 20 years, he has finished within 4 months. A lot of achievements. I can go on saying this, but all those are past. My only thing we can say that really the library profession and the library fraternity has lost a great person, a human being like Sitaraman, because he used to, as a student, we used to go to his lectures, listen to his lectures, go to NAF. Okay. Even after joining the IIT Madras, still he was our mentor. So in that sense, he's a great personality. And we really hope that, people will take some lesson from his achievements. And the next generation, we are really fortunate to be in this generation because we have some stalwarts like Sitaraman, Parsati, Anil Megan, and all these people, Gopinath and all. So we are fortunate to go in those systems. But unfortunately, today, the youngsters need some kind of motivation from prominent people like this. So I would like to pass on this message to the younger generation so that they also can imbibe the qualities of a good leadership qualities like Sitaraman, and then try to come up in their career. Now, what else I can say, but pray Lord that we send to his family to their grief, and may he rest up, her soul rest in. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. Now I request Dr. Purnima Narayan. Over to Dr. Purnima Narayan, madam. Dr. Purnima Narayan.
Hello.
Yes, madam, please go ahead.
Yeah, I can, okay. Thank you. At the outset, I would like to thank Kalam and especially my great friend, Dr. M. Krishnamurti and Dr. Asundi for having given me a chance to speak, to offer my views and experiences under a great personality that was our M.N. Sitaraman, popularly fondly called as MNS Sir. I remember the day I walked into NA Library when I joined way back in on 15th February 1978. I was a very raw, just fresh out of the college, university. And after a brief session, he just gave me a picture, just a bird's eye view of the about our profession, because whatever we had studied in the university was far different from our practical experience. So the way he explained, just within half an hour, I could make out, I could say that he was an exemplary professional with deep insight and a dynamic leader and dedicated professional. Above all, I could make out whatever little experience I had, he was a great visionary. Ahead of times in foreseeing, planning new initiatives and introducing quality-based services. His introduction of SDI services at NAL was so popular among scientists. Come Monday, they used to rush to our center and get whatever the output they wanted to continue with their projects. Sir was, got so much. He's such an accomplished person, and his contributions to our L&IS, not only to our L&IS, he was a person with, he had so many qualities. He kept himself up to date with all sorts of knowledge, not only forget about our profession, be it general knowledge, politics, current scenario, sports to some extent, and movies also. Then, because already I think my predecessors have already mentioned his contribution, his initiative in setting up satellite-based information retrieval system, European Space Agency through dedicated line system housed at Frascati, Rome. He was, and most of our discussions used to be held in the corridors of ICAST, where still his contagious laughter still rooms. I remember that. He used to call every one of us, each one of us used to come out of the room, and he used to say that, you know, we should give publicity, we should make this. Always he was, the very quote he said was, I remember, he said, you know, how much our publicity should be, it should be like Nirma powder advertisement. You remember, all of you, that those days Nirma was the top of the TRP ratings. So his ideas, you know, ways thinking up, his vision was too far. What we all used to think on that day, he used to think personality. And imagine, just when he took over, because I had joined them, but all the whole NAL scientists, management, they used to tell me that the day he took over the library, then it was known as the NAL library, which was housed in the in a small room at the Wind Tunnel Center with just three almirahs housing just 300 documents. And within no time, with great effort and through so many exchange programs and setting up with labs and resource sharing with our libraries. We were, the NAL was one of the first institutes to go for exchange program. In fact, he encouraged me to conduct a survey in which we found out that with 59 international world-repute aerospace and related organizations, we had exchange programs like NASA, 16 units of NASA, AGARD, ONERA, DLR, NAL Japan, so and so. So, but this his vision was so far-fetched, you know. And another thing is his way of he had to work hard to convince our NAL management to get to enhance our budget, our infrastructure, build up our infrastructure, and introduce IT-based quality services. Such was his camaraderie and rapport with the NAL management. Ask anything, just say a little one para-sentence, write down, and immediately sanction. Dr. Valuri was always, I think Dr. Raghavan mentioned, yes, Dr. Valuri also always used to say that if Sitaraman is given the freedom to lead NAL, he will make NAL a part of the library, not the other way. He was such a praiseworthy person. And so many things, you know, so I can go on and on, but for the time constraint, I think many people would have there. And I'm very proud to say that I just worked under him for more than a decade. I was the only person till now, and till the date, till the last moment, just 2 weeks before his demise, I talked to him. He talked to me from his hospital bed in a very feeble voice. Immediately, I alerted my other colleagues to give an update about his health. And 2 weeks down the line, he was no more. Anyway, one more thing, his personality as a human being, apart from other his professional activities, a very calm, very cool dude. He was a cool dude. I used to think in my mind. And with very smiling face, with a very contagious laughter. In fact, many scientists used to complain that in our ICA, those days it was not ICA. I mean, a few of his society, other colleagues and MNS were the ones who used to make lots of noise by their contagious laughter. And he was a very hard taskmaster, no compromise with work. That was his motto. He seldom used to get angry. I never remember him flying into a temper, flying in a rage. He used to get things done in his own way. Such was his... until the last moment, he was so active. One word, because his Sakala Vidya Parangata. He was editing the Sanskrit journal, and he used to send me some of his articles. So I couldn't understand much. Still, hats off, sir, hats off. And another person at other treats in him. He's God fearing, very religious and family person. Vedas and shlokas always used to like run like a tap water to him in his some of the discourses. He used to tell me about some of the Vedas shlokas a little bit, whatever I could grasp, I used to. So I think that he lived a very contented life in his personal life, though he was never satisfied professionally to keep updating himself till the last minute. He wanted to update, to know the current situation, to know to how to enhance our profession. He said, Dr. Gaur, very close, most of our colleagues were close to mommy because of her Delhi cases. She used to prepare such nice Delhi cases. We used to go for that. And their five children, all are very well settled and all, though there was a tragedy in his life. So he has been, personally, he was a guide because he always used to advise me, Purnima, keep yourself updated. Go on reading. Go on updating your knowledge, whatever thoughts, you can get new thoughts, you can come up with new ideas so that you can put your center to the top of the ladder. So guide, my teacher, my motivator, encouraging and inspiring me to adapt to the latest technologies in library and information service. Sir, your demise is an irreparable loss to almost all the people you knew, relatives, friends, and to me, it's a very personal loss. I still remember his smiling face, sir, my namana, wherever you are, continue to be in peace and keep on showering your blessings, ashirvadas to us, sir, and my condolences to the family members. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti.
Thank you, madam. Thank you for your, now I request to give respect to Mr. Kotai. Over to Kotai. Kotai.
Krishnamurti can put his name in the last. He will be joining.
Because okay.
Traveling.
Okay, now we will ask Dr. N.V. Satyanarayana, sir. Satyanarayana, sir, please over to N.V. Satyanarayana.
Good evening, friends. It's very sad to hear about a lot of our professional colleagues and the members of the club becoming victims of COVID. I pray for all of them, for their soul to rest in peace. Mr. Sitaraman is a very interesting personality, very highly well-respected leader of all times. In our younger generation, that was the period when I was in my youthful time. He was a role model as a practicing librarian for most of us in those days, for all of us, I would say. Everyone would look for him as to what new things he is doing. And as Raghavan said, he was a great organizer and exceptionally smart and intelligent administrator. And I used to think, is this man a kind of a man in a hurry? The kind of agility he had in doing things is remarkable. You know, if I say that in those days, in my early days, it was just about the time I was also planning to start informatics. You would all be surprised to know that I looked at him as a kind of a computational inspiration. He was perhaps the only librarian who I looked at as a kind of a computational inspiration. And in those days, just after starting informatics, it was in the very early stage. It was still not totally public in a way. And I met him a couple of times to take his, to pick his brains. You know, some of the very novel, interesting and innovation things he did in his time is remarkable. A couple of things I still remember, which gave us inspiration to do a lot of new things. One was, as someone mentioned, he was the first librarian to experiment airlifting journals.
Shankar.
And he was a very, he was a very courageous man, an unusual librarian working in a government organization who took all the courage to take the risk. And he managed to establish an arrangement with a company called Bumpus Haldane to airlift the journal. And I guess he wanted that to be a kind of a cooperative model. But NAL did it and did it for a long time, I guess. Now, he really set the, you know, benchmark for the libraries. In fact, as Gowda was telling, he was one of those two who very early applied ICT, for library application. As early as in those days, I used to follow him, reading whatever he wrote. He didn't write too much. And, you know, I think because he was a great practicing librarian and he believed perhaps in doing things more than writing about it. And of course, he talked a lot about what he did. And he was a great marketing man, par excellence, I would say. I still remember all the articles he wrote in Decidoc Journal on marketing information products in those early days. And another article in those early days in 70s, imagine in late 70s, writing an article on application of electronic data for electronic data processing equipment for processing bibliographic data. As a co-author with one of his colleagues in NAL, I think it was Mr. Rao, N.J. Rao, with whom he co-authored that paper. And it shows how he was within his organization collaborative with beyond the library. And friends, another thing, in fact, the Bumpus Haldane experience for airlifting, I learned a lot from his experience, and we started very early airlifting journals when we started informatics in those days. And another area where, you know, we somewhat crossed the path and we used to exchange a lot of ideas. And he did that kind of a courage with which he moved, I can't remember a librarian of that courage and agility and innovative capability to do something very innovative always and to be ahead of time. And he was a great inspirational leader for all of us. We really, really miss him. Even until his, even at 90s, he was very active. I haven't anytime seen him as an inactive person at all. Always active, bubbling with enthusiasm. And we really, really miss him. And I pray for his soul to rest in peace. I pay my homage. a great leader of our times. Thank you, Kala, for this opportunity.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Now I request Mr. Nagarajan Sitaraman, elder son of M.N. Sitaraman. Over to Nagarajan, sir, please.
Yeah, can you hear me now?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, good evening, everybody. And at the outset, I would like to thank Karnataka Library Association for organizing this wonderful evening. My father, wherever he is, if he is watching, he would be very, very delighted. His total passion was library science and information technology. And throughout my growing up years, when I was young, I used to hear him with a very passionate discussion with his colleagues. Whenever they used to visit our house, his topic used to be library science, future, technology, satellites, and those things. Sometimes these discussions used to go very late in the evening, where my mother used to really step in and take care of these discussions. And for him, library science was his passion. And at home, he was a very strict disciplinarian. And he used to instill us a sense of commitment, hard work, and he used to motivate us to get a good education, which will be a solid foundation. Now, when I look back, I find that in 30 years, all of us, my two brothers, my two sisters and a brother, we all have been reasonably come, and you would be really happy with the way we have shaped up. And thanks to him for all his kindness, the motivation. He was a very strict disciplinarian. And all my friends, my school friends, used to call him Joe Fraser because he used to be so strict at coming back and studying at the proper time and sleeping at a proper time. For that, Father, I'm really grateful. Yeah, I really used to love him dearly. I used to respect him a lot. And I used to visit a man. I retired as a commander from the Indian Navy. I've settled in Chennai because I'm taking classes for this much in marine segment. And I also used to sail part-time here in Chennai. So that's why I chose Chennai. And since Bangalore is almost like a suburb, or Chennai is a suburb of Bangalore, I used to commute very frequently. The last visit was in the month of March when I came there. He asked me one question as to what is a good mutual fund for old age. So at 95, he was still thinking that old age is some time away. So that was my father, who never gave up. Even this hospital bed, he was talking to me, he was sending messages. He was sending messages to everybody. He was so active, so full of life. So, and his zest for life is something to be seen. I'm really going to miss him. All as a, on behalf of our family, we are really now headless, and we need to pick up and move forward. And I take this opportunity once again to thank Kala for organizing Dr. Asundi, and particular mention to Dr. Krishnamurthy, and as well as to Dr. Gowder, who in a short time contacted so many people and could make this event possible. Thank you very much. And I thank you from the bottom of my heart. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Now I request to Dr. P.V. Patavardhan. Patavardhan, sir, over to Patavardhan.
Hello.
Yes, sir. Please go ahead.
Hello, good evening. Hello, good evening.
Yes, sir. Good evening.
I am Mr. Patavardhan speaking. And I work under Sipa Sitaraman long back during 1975 to 76 for a very short period of 16 months. And within that period, I was very much influenced by his way of dealing with his subordinates, getting the work done, be friendly. As soon as I joined, I joined as a cataloger, and he gave me some guidelines that you do your work of cataloging also involve with the users for guiding them in the collection of books and documents. Because NAL was following at that time Kolan classification, which was a bit difficult for users to follow. So I used to be with the scientists in the reference section, and stack rooms for helping them. And he was deputed to Luxembourg for those days for computer applications to libraries. At that time, he also left TRNL and joined Kirloskar Electric. Soon after joining Kirloskar Electric, I used to meet him in NL and ask sometimes some advice on how to run the show. Yes, he was very quite helpful, and I have a great record on him. So with this departure, a library field has lost a great personality. I wish his soul to attain moksha, and also condolences to his family. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much, sir. Now you have almost come to an end. Now our Professor A.Y. Asundi, Karnataka Library Association President, presidential remarks. Over to Professor Asundi, sir. Over to Professor Asundi, sir.
Okay. In the couple of last 2-3 months, we have lost 4 professionals, among which Mr. M. N. Sitaraman was the latest one, and Dr. Rudresh Kumbar from National Law School of India University, who has served as a librarian and started his career from the scratch in that particular library. Then Mr. R. Dandapani, and probably you may be aware that Mr. Dandapani also had got the honor of MBE from the British Empire, because the Prince Charles, who visited the library and used to show me the photo and also the MBE, and Mr. M. N. Sitaraman. And I recollect when I visited the probably I'm the one, the earliest one to visit the NL Library in 1965, when I was on the library tour as a student of library science. And afterwards, I moved to Bangalore in 1979. I had a very close contact with Mr. M. N. Sitaraman and used to always welcome with very smiles and very affectionate smile. And in 1986, I had an opportunity to participate in the online informative services and demo. And later also, when I was working in IIM, I used to visit the NAL quite often to collect a lot of information from the, and always we had a very welcome to me to that library. And I endorse all the opinions expressed by his colleagues and others, and also on my personal behalf. And I used to get a newsletter from the NAL right from the very beginning. Even when I was in KRAC, I used to get that newsletter. And it was very informative. Particularly one thing that I still remember, when I was writing a book on stockification, and he had sent me the complete the brochure of the stockification process done in the NAL library. And in fact, that particular document has become one of the references in my book. And that was the kind of the inputs Mr. M. N. Sitaraman used to give. And used to call quite often whenever any assistance required. And as Mr. Satyanarayan and others have mentioned, he has one of the best marketing abilities in the profession, and a very great allies profession. I thank Mr. Nagaraj and his son for participating in this condolence meeting. I thank all the colleagues and others for having joined in this particular condolence meeting. Thank you once again for all of you. Thank you. Okay.
Krishnamurthy, sir.
Yes, thank you, sir. Thank you all. Okay.